हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई वेलकम यू ऑल फॉर द लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ डिजिटल सिग्नल प्रोसेसिंग। सो टुडे इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द न्यू टॉपिक दैट इज डिस्क्रीट फोरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म, ओके, विच इज DFT। सो वी हैव ऑलरेडी कवर्ड द जेड ट्रांसफॉर्म इन द प्रीवियस सेशंस। सो नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस विच इज द न्यू टॉपिक, ओके, एंड विच इज द मेथड which is used to analysis the discrete time signal, okay? So this is the method, that is DFT, which is used to analysis the discrete time sequence, okay, discrete frequency sequence. So for the digital signal, DFT and Z transform is used for the analysis. So let's discuss the DFT, that is discrete Fourier transform. The definition of DFT is, it is finite duration discrete frequency sequence, okay, it is finite duration discrete frequency sequence which is obtained by sampling one period of Fourier transform, okay, which is obtained by sampling one period of Fourier transform. This sampling is done at n equally spaced points over the period extending from w is equal to 0 to 2 pi, okay. So the mathematical equations given by the DFT of discrete sequence x of n is denoted by x of k, okay. So please remember, like we have studied in the Z transform, so the Z transform of x of n was the x of z. Similarly, the DFT of discrete sequence, DFT of discrete sequence, we all know that is discrete sequence is denoted by x of n. So the DFT of this sequence, which is the discrete sequence, is denoted by x of k, okay. So x of k is nothing but the DFT of x of n, okay. X of k is nothing but the DFT of x of n. So what is the formula for x of k? The formula is given, that is x of k is equal to summation of n is equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of n into e raised to minus j 2 pi k n divided by n. Here k is equal to 0, 1, 2 up to n minus 1. So this is the formula for the discrete Fourier transform, which is always denoted by x of k, and we are finding DFT of x of n, okay. X of n is nothing but the discrete sequence or digital signal, okay. So please remember, this is the most basic equation of the DFT and which will be used everywhere to solve problems on the DFT, like in the Z transform. So again, I repeat, the DFT of x of n is summation of n is equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of n into e raised to minus j 2 pi k n divided by n. So please remember this equation, and it is called as n point DFT, okay. It is called as n point DFT. So in the problem, the question may ask on the 2 point DFT, 4 point DFT, 8 point DFT, likewise, okay. So according to the points of the DFT are given, you have to solve the problem. So it will be more clear when we solve the problems on the DFT. So now let's discuss the next equation. So this is the basic equation of the DFT. The next will be inverse DFT, okay, inverse discrete Fourier transform. So we can obtain discrete sequence x of n from its DFT, okay. Now we are going to obtain this x of n, okay, from x of k, okay. This is nothing but the inverse discrete Fourier transform, okay. So ultimately the equation for x of n is given, which is nothing but the inverse discrete Fourier transform. So x of n is given by 1 by capital N summation of k is equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of k into e raised to j 2 pi k n divided by n. So here is no minus sign, okay, like in the equation of DFT, okay, when we want to find out the DFT of particular sequence, there was the minus sign here. But in the case of IDFT, inverse discrete Fourier transform, here is a no minus sign, okay. So this is the equation for IDFT and this is equation for DFT. So you have to remember these two equations, which will be very useful to solve examples on the DFT. So again, this equation is called n point IDFT, okay. This is n point inverse discrete Fourier transform. So again, the next thing will be Tweedell factor, okay. The next thing is Tweedell factor. So what is this Tweedell factor? Now we will define the new term, that is W. So W is nothing but the Tweedell factor. So WN is equal to e raised to minus j 2 pi divided by n. So this is the equation of Tweedell factor, which is given by e raised to minus j 2 pi divided by n, okay. So what is the use of this Tweedell factor, okay? Why we want to use this Tweedell factor in the IDFT and DFT? Because this Tweedell factor makes computation of the DFT, okay. This Tweedell factor makes computation of the DFT a bit easy and fast, okay. That means we can solve the summations or the computation of the DFT very easily by using this Tweedell factor. So if you see, this is the basic equation of this Tweedell factor. So the Tweedell factor can be put in the equations of IDFT and DFT, okay. So in the term of Tweedell factor, we can write these above two equations, okay. In the term of Tweedell factor, we can write the equations of DFT and IDFT likewise. So here the equation in the terms of Tweedell factor, this is for DFT and this is for IDFT. So after putting WN is equal to e raised to minus j 2 pi divided by n in the equation of DFT, okay, just put equation of this Tweedell factor, okay, in this equation of DFT. So what we will get? We will get this term, that is x of k is equal to summation of n is equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of n into WN raised to kn. So where this kn comes, because only kn will be remaining, kn will be remaining, okay, in this equation, okay. If we put Tweedell factor in this equation, so the equation of Tweedell factor is e raised to minus j 2 pi divided by n, okay. So remaining thing will be k into small n, remaining thing will be k into small n. So it will become W raised to kn, okay. So likewise, we have obtained these two equations. So the first equation, that is x of k, which is nothing but the DFT of the discrete sequence in the terms of Tweedell factor. So this is the Tweedell factor in this equation, that is W raised to kn. And the for IDFT, the Tweedell factor is given here, that is again W raised to kn, okay. So most of the time you have to use these two equations, okay, in the terms of Tweedell factor. So please remember, these are the normal equations of the DFT and IDFT, okay. And in the terms of Tweedell factor, these are the equations, like this is for DFT and this is for IDFT, okay. So please remember these equations. Now we will solve one common simple example on the DFT. So the example is given, compute n point dft of x of n is equal to e raised to j in bracket 2 pi by n into k0 into n. Okay, and the condition is given, n is greater than 0, okay, but less than n minus 1. Small n is greater than 0 but less than n minus 1. So we have to find out the dft of this sequence, okay, the sequence given in the x of n form. We want to find out dft, so our answer will be x of k form, okay, and we already known the formula of x of k, that is basic formula of dft, okay, in the terms of Tweedle factor also. So we will see whether it is useful to solve this example using this Tweedle factor. So let's solve this example, which is very simple one. So ultimately this is our given example, okay. So according to definition of DFT, we know that x of k is equal to summation of n is equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of n e raised to minus j 2 pi k n divided by n. So this is the basic equation of the DFT, okay, we have studied this. So let's put x of n here, okay, just put x of n is here. So what is the value of x of n? X of n is given in our problem. So this x of n is nothing but this problem which is given in this equation, that is x of n is equal to e raised to j 2 pi divided by n k n. So just put it here, okay, put x of n here. So we will get x of k is equal to this summation as it is, that is summation of n is equal to 0 to n minus 1. This is the value of x of n, that is e raised to j 2 pi k n divided by n into this remaining term, okay. We have just put the x of n value and multiply with this term. So this term is remain as it is, that is e raised to minus j 2 pi k n divided by n. So the next thing will be just multiply this. So x of k is equal to n minus 1 divided by, sorry, x of k is equal to summation of n is equal to 0 to n minus 1 in bracket e raised to j 2 pi divided by n. Just take this common 2 pi by n and again here j 2 pi by n. So remaining will be k 0. So remaining term will be k 0 minus k. Okay. So what we did here, just take out this common things. Okay. So what is the common? J 2 pi, j 2 pi and divided by n. Okay. These are the common. So just we have put, just we have take this common, that is e raised to j 2 pi by n in bracket k 0 minus k and in multiply with this n. Okay. So this n will be outside the bracket. So just we have arranged this equation in this form. Okay. Just we have arranged this two, this multiplication in this form. Okay. So just use the basic formula summation, which is called standard summation formula, which you have studied earlier in the mathematics subject, okay, and you have to remember this formula to solve any problem on the DFT. You have to remember this formula. So this is the important formula for standard summation, that is given by summation of n is equal to n1 to n2 into a raised to n is equal to the first term a raised to n1 minus a raised to n2 plus 1 divided by 1 minus a, okay, if a is not is equal to 1, and the next will be n2 minus n1 plus 1 if a is equal to 1. So please by heart this formula, okay, just remember this formula, which is always used to solve the problems on the DFT and which is already covered in the mathematics subject. So this is nothing but the standard summation formula, which always used to solve DFT. So by just compare this formula with our equation, okay, so by comparing this formula with our equation, we will get x of k is equal to, okay, a raised to n means our equation. So this is our equation, Okay, after multiplication we have solved this. So e raised to j 2 pi by n, which we have already taken common, in bracket k 0 minus k, so raised to 0. Okay, first put n is equal to 0. Okay, so here is a, here was the n1. What is our n1? The first limit of summation, which was the 0. Okay, so just we have put this value of n1. So n1 is nothing but the 0 minus in bracket e raised to j 2 pi by n, again in bracket k 0 minus k. Now put n2 minus 1. Okay, put the power n2 minus n2 plus 1. So what is our n2? So n2 nothing but the n minus 1. Okay, which was the upper limit. Okay, n1 was the lower limit, which is nothing but the 0, and n2 was the upper limit, which is nothing but the n minus 1. Okay, so just we have put this value of n1 and n2 here. So n1 was the 0 and n2 is n minus 1 plus 1, this plus 1 as it is. Okay, and divided by this 1 minus a. So 1 minus our equation, a is nothing but our equation. So what was the our equation? E raised to j 2 pi by n k 0 minus k. So this is the our equation. So likewise, we have already solved this example. We find out the last answer, that is e raised to this 0 multiply with this bracket. So e raised to 0 is 1. Okay, e raised to 0 is 1, and multiply this n minus 1 plus 1 to this bracket. So what will remain? So this minus 1 plus 1 gets cancelled, this n and this n will become gets cancelled. So the remaining term will be e raised to j 2 pi k 0 minus k. So divided by this term as it is. Okay, this denominator as it is, that is 1 minus e raised to j 2 pi divided by n in bracket k 0 minus k. So likewise, we have solved the simple example of the DFT, or we can say the problem on the definition of the DFT, which was the very simple one. Okay, you have to solve very tough examples on the DFT, but this is what the very simple. You have to do one thing. Just remember this formula, the standard summation formula, which will be always used to solve the DFT. Here A is nothing but our equation, which we have already find out. Okay, and N1 is the lower limit, and N2 is the upper limit. Okay, just put that limit here, use this equation. Okay, and find out the answer. So likewise, we have solved this example. Again, I want to show you one more example, which is also simple one. So the next example is compute n point DFT of finite length sequence, where x of n is given by 1. Okay, for n is greater than 0 and less than n minus 1, and 0 for otherwise. So just we have to find out the DFT of this 1. Okay, so let's find out this DFT of the sequence x of n. So again, it will be in the x of k form. So according to definition of DFT, we have this equation, our standard equation of DFT, that is x of k is equal to summation of n is equal to 0 to n minus 1 into x of n e raised to minus j 2 pi k n divided by n. So as we have x of n value, which is nothing but the 1. Okay, x of n is 1. So just put x of n is 1 here. So we will get this. So we have just put x of n is equal to 1. So the remaining term will be x of k is equal to summation of n is equal to 0 to n minus 1 e raised to minus j 2 pi k n divided by n raised to n. So we have made this arrangement. Okay, just we are converting this equation into this equation. Okay, this to this. Wait, this equation we are converting in this form. So again, use the standard summation formula. So this our, so this is the standard summation formula. Okay, so what we have, n1 is equal to 0. Okay, n1 is nothing but the lower limit, So this is our equation after arrangement. Okay, we have this formula of the standard summation formula. By using this formula, we have to find out the DFT of this sequence. So we have n1 is equal to 0, so lower limit is 0. n2 is n minus 1, this is n minus 1, which is nothing but the n2. Okay, and a is the our equation. The equation is what? E raised to minus j 2 pi k n divided by n, which is our a. Okay, so we have already find, we have already known n1, n2 and a. Just put the values here. So after putting this value, we got this e raised to minus j 2 pi divided by n raised to 0. How this 0 comes? Because of there is a n1. And what is our n1? n1 is 0. Minus e raised to minus j 2 pi k n divided by n raised to n2 plus 1. n2 is what? N minus 1 plus 1. Okay. So this is the n minus 1 plus 1. Just multiply this in this bracket. So the remaining term will be e raised to 0 is 1. So this 1. Okay. This 1 minus e raised to, okay, please do correction here. Here will be 1 minus e raised to, okay, this 1 become cancel, this n become cancel, the remaining term will be minus j 2 pi k, minus j 2 pi k. Okay, so please do correction here. This is the wrong numerator, print mistake is here, wrong numerator is given. So at the numerator, the term will be 1 minus e raised to minus j 2 pi k divided by this denominator as it is. That is 1 minus e raised to minus j 2 pi k divided by n. So this is the final answer, or nothing but the DFT of the given sequence. Okay. So likewise, we have convert the x of n into x of k by using the standard definition of the DFT and by using standard summation formula. Okay, so that's it for the today. In the next session, we will solve two more examples on the DFT, which will be little bit difficult as compared to today's session. Okay, so thank you very much.